Judiciary Committee will convene and discuss the articles of impeachment. By Thursday, the committee could hold votes on amendments, moving one step closer to a momentous vote on whether to remove the president from office.
We must be clear. No one, not even the president, is above the law.
Democratic congressional leaders unveiled articles of impeachment charging President Trump with, quote, abuse of power and obstruction of Congress.
Our president holds the ultimate public trust. When he betrays that trust and puts himself before country, he endangers the Constitution, he endangers our democracy, and he endangers our national security.
The articles represent a formal call for the president's removal from office. The articles are just 9 pages long, accusing the president of, quote, corruptly soliciting help in the 2020 election from the government of Ukraine. The articles conclude that the president used 2 official acts of the presidency, the delivery of $391 million in military aid and a White House meeting to the president of Ukraine to investigate and help smear his political rivals.
The evidence of the president's misconduct is overwhelming and uncontested. And how could it not be when the president's own words on July 25th, "I would like you to do us a favor, though," lays so bare his intentions.
The second article charges that the president harmed Congress by ordering all of his aides, appointees, and staff to defy House subpoenas.
If allowed to stand, it would decimate Congress's ability to conduct oversight of this president or any other in the future.
After the announcement, the president tweeted, "witch hunt," in all caps.
The Republicans have stuck together. There's a witch hunt. It's a terrible thing.
And Illinois Republican Congressman Darren LaHood argued that the election should decide Trump's future.
We ought to be putting that into the hands of the people. Let's have an election. You're going to have lots of choices. Let the people decide whether the conduct was inappropriate or not.
The argument, "why don't you just wait," amounts to this. Why don't you just let him cheat in one more election? Why not let him cheat just one more time?
The governor of Illinois says he believes Trump should be removed from office.
It is clear to me that significant evidence has been put forward that shows that President Trump has committed misdeeds, that he's committed wrongdoing, that impeachment is warranted by the House of Representatives.
Judiciary Committee could vote on the articles of impeachment by Thursday and send them to the full House of Representatives for a vote before Christmas.
When is their recess?
I believe coming up very
shortly. Okay, so they want to do it before then, right?
Indeed.
Yeah.
And everyone seems locked in. There's no reason to believe that anything as far as the dialogue will change over the next couple of days.
Yeah, it looks like everything's falling on party lines, though. In the Senate, Mitt Romney, the senator now from Utah, says he's keeping an open mind. So there is this chance that there could be a bipartisan vote on the removal from office if it gets to that point, but we're still a few steps from there.
All right, Mike, thanks. Coming up.